About that for a lovely scaly one. Absolutely gorgeous. Only about 17 pound, but what a stunning fish this is. Caught this one using them bait tech boilies. So testing them out at the minute. It's going absolutely pucker. So really happy with this one. Yep. Thank you. Yeah, easy bits. Right, I really have got something proper special here for you all to see. An absolute stunning mirror carp. All £37 of it, so I think she wants to play ball. I'll show you. What a gorgeous beast this is. Have a look at that. £37 right on the button. And what a belting looking carp. Caught them bait head baits. Oh my God. It's a proper everyone. Absolutely gorgeous. Look at that. Yes. Mwah. Thank you. Oh, right. Turn her around. Proper, proper chuff for this one. £37 on the new bait head bait. And things couldn't be any better. Happy days. What a gorgeous looking creature. So, so happy with this, is unbelievable. Thank you very much.
Creature, what a beautiful baby she is. Mwah. Thank you, my darling.
So I had one night left of my week off to go, and a weather warning was issued out across the country saying that some mini hurricane was going to turn up, it was going to be savage storm and everything. Missus was saying to me, you better get yourself home. Parents were saying to me, you shouldn't be out there, you should be getting home. But I knew the session weren't over, and I knew that there was, you know, feeding fish out there. I knew I was going to catch another. So I basically battened down the hatches, stayed on for me last night, and I'll let the rest unfold for you.
Right, well, I'm out in this savage storm. I don't know if you can see that down there, but look, there's a coot that's decided to take refuge on my bucket, bless him. It's getting blown around in the wind down there. I've got a fish on my left hand rod, which has weeded me up massively. My middle rod started to go. The old coot there is hanging on for dear old life, bless him. I don't know if you can see that, but... Right. From me and the coot, good night.
So on the next morning, that left-hand rod still had that same fish on it. I did manage in the darkness to get him out of the weed bed, and then he ended up in another weed bed, and I had to put the rod back down, and then I got him out of another weed bed, sort of had a fight with him out in the middle of the lake, and then he ended up in another weed bed. So I just kept putting the rod down and hoping for the best. And then finally, God knows how many hours after, it finally broke away. And you can see this weed that I'm sort of dragging in here. Now, he didn't give me a fight whatsoever as it broke away, so I wasn't 100% sure whether the fish was still in there or not. So I'm sort of having a look here, is he still there? Couldn't really see anything. Then I just slightly saw the weed bed move a little bit, which obviously got me reaching for the landing net, but still wasn't 100% sure whether he was there or not, because I hadn't properly seen him. But I'm having a look here, and then I saw him right underneath the weed. He was done in and then ready for netting.
Oh, the relief.
I'm waking up to ash and dust. I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals. I'm breaking in, shaping up, then checking out on the prison bus. This is it, the apocalypse. Whoa, I'm waking up.
So I managed to finally bank this beautiful 37 pounder. What a glorious looking carp that is. Fish known as a Brown's Mate, I believe. Thanks to my young friend Kai, my little cameraman. But what a glorious looking carp that is. Wow, chuffed. Happy, happy days. Yes! Right. Right.
Just got out.
We could have told. One day, baby, we'll be old.